I think this has happened to all of us at some point. You're trying to connect to either a hotel Wi-Fi or a cafe or something and log in, and you can't get the stupid login page for the Wi-Fi to show up. Or maybe it came up, you dismissed it by accident, and you can't get it back. But there are a few tricks that I'm going to teach you in this video where you'll never have to worry about that again, including a website that you probably never heard of before but is extremely useful and you'll want to remember. The first thing to try, assuming the login portal didn't show up automatically like it should, is, depending on whether you're on iOS or Android, go to your respective network settings in your phone. So on iOS, you would go to the Wi-Fi settings and then that Wi-Fi network's network options. And on Android, you go to the Wi-Fi settings and then network details for it. And in here, you're going to be looking for a feature. On iOS, it's going to be called Open Portal Page. And on Android, it's called Open Site. Now, this might not always show up. This is going to depend if the router and the network is configured well, which is a big if. Not all of them are going to support it. I'll get to the technicals of why that is later. So definitely do not assume this is going to show up every single time. For you IT people out there, technically speaking, it depends on whether the network implements DHCP option 114. But I'll explain the technical stuff later for those of you who are interested. And I believe on Windows, it doesn't have such a feature, surprisingly. So you would just have to do one of the things I'm going to talk about next. So if that option does not show up on iOS or Android for that network, then the next thing to try is go to this website. It's called neverssl.com. And the way it works is, for context, when you go to connect to a Wi-Fi hotspot that does redirect you to that login page, what it does is basically looks for any traffic that you're trying to access the internet and redirects you to the login page, unless you're authenticated with it, like it recognizes your device. So it effectively does kind of like a man in the middle attack. And if your browser, like it does usually by default, tries to use SSL to encrypt the connection to whatever website you're trying to go to, a lot of times this redirect doesn't work or doesn't work as well. Because the router might still try to redirect the traffic, but the browser is going to recognize, wait a minute, this certificate that I'm seeing probably from the web captive portal, because it'll have its own certificate, is not going to match what you just typed in. So it might just block the connection altogether to the captive portal or show an error. So it will be hard to get to it. But the reason going to neverssl.com works is it does not force you to use the HTTPS site like most websites do. And if you're wondering why you would have to bother using neverssl.com when doing that, and why not just use any other website, I will get to that. Now, some of you clever people might be wondering, wait a minute, if I'm behind the captive portal and I can't access the internet, how does the browser even know whether or not the NeverSSL website supports HTTPS or not? And that is a good question, because actually these days browsers try to force SSL and HTTPS from the get-go. So what you could do is try to explicitly put http://NeverSSL to force it to try non-encrypted first. However, even sometimes if you explicitly type in HTTP, a lot of browsers will sometimes force it anyway, and the NeverSSL site actually has that in mind and has one final trick up its sleeve. See, if you visit NeverSSL, when you do have access to the internet, it has special code on its site that redirects to the HTTP version. And what happens is the browser will cache that redirect. So if you visit the NeverSSL site at any point before going behind the captive portal, and then you do go to use it, it'll remember that redirect to the non-encrypted version. And then at that point, the router can step in and detect it and redirect you. So in other words, if you're on your phone, for example, what you can do is, if you can't get the NeverSSL site to work, disconnect from the Wi-Fi and use cellular and go to neverssl.com, and then it'll cache that thing and then retry connecting to the captive portal through it, and it should work. Like, for example, you can see here that I set up a captive portal on my router, and if I go to neverssl.com, it does work. And since I have visited the NeverSSL site before, even if I explicitly put the HTTPS, it still redirects it fine and works. Now, before I show you some other extra things you can try, something else that's really useful is today's sponsor, Aura. You see, there's all these sketchy data brokers out there who collect and sell your information to scammers, spammers, and anyone else who may want to target you. I'm talking your full name, email, home address, health records, your relatives, it's all out there. But that's where Aura comes in. For example, it can show me which data brokers are selling my info and automatically submit opt-out requests for me. Cleaning up this info not only helps me reduce the amount of spam coming my way, but also protects me from hackers who might leverage this info to try and access my accounts or even do personalized phishing attacks. I was even surprised when it showed me that the collected public info out there even included what kind of car I drive. But Aura also has a ton of other features, such as antivirus, a VPN, password management, parental controls, identity theft insurance, all in one place, instead of needing a whole bunch of separate apps. Even if you already have one or two of these tools, you could still be leaving doors open to bad actors. But Aura is always on, so you can have peace of mind and focus on other important stuff. To get started, you can go to aura.com/theojo to start your 2-week free trial. Link is also in the description. And with all that being said, let's continue. Now, in addition to NeverSSL.com, there are some other sites you can try that might work. For example, this is the one that Apple devices use to test whether they can access the internet. It's captive.apple.com. And then this other one is for Android. It's connectivitycheck.gstatic.com. Those also apparently both do not force encryption. However, they're not going to have the extra stuff that NeverSSL does for like forcing the redirect, specifically designed to get the captive portal to work. So you could try those, but they might not work. Another thing you could try that sometimes might work is going directly to the router's IP address. So you can access this on iOS, again, just in the Wi-Fi network settings. Just go to where it says router and just long press to copy that and try going to that in the browser. And on Android, again, it's in there. And this time it's called gateway. It means the same thing. You just copy it, try that. All right, now you might be wondering, okay, so assuming we're behind the captive portal, why bother using HTTP NeverSSL.com? Why can't you just use any other website? And that is because of a feature called HSTS, or HTTP Strict Transport Security. This is a network standard that most websites support, and it basically tells the web browser when you visit it, hey, always use the HTTPS version of this website. Even if the user types in the non-encrypted version, just go to the HTTPS version. And that happens the first time you visit it. And since most websites you would think to try this on, you probably visited before, and your browser knows that that's in there, it's not going to work. It's going to just go to the HTTPS site. It's not going to even try the unencrypted version. And actually, on top of that, all the major web browsers have a massive list of websites that support this strict transport security thing, which most websites do, and it's like hard-coded into the actual installation of the browser. So even if you're not connected to the internet and you type in a website like google.com, HTTP, it's gonna see that in the list and not even ever bother to try the unencrypted version. This list is called the HSTS preload list, and basically all of them, all the web browsers use the same one created by Google for Chromium browsers. If you're curious, you can download the whole thing through this URL. It's about a 20 megabyte file, so very huge, so it might be hard to search through it. Or an easier way to check is if you go in a Chromium-based browser to this URL, it should open up this thing, which shows some information about it, and then you can query the domain with this option and check if it's in there. So for example, my website, theojo.com, does support it, and if I haven't visited the site on this browser before and type that in, it's gonna say it wasn't found. But the second I visit that site, the browser now receives that information and knows. So if I go and check it again, you can see it now shows information. So any time going forward, if I try to access it unencrypted, it's just gonna force it to be encrypted. Anyway, the reason all this is relevant is because NeverSSL doesn't force it and doesn't have this HSTS thing. So it's not gonna try and force it if the browser doesn't already. All right, now some more technicals on what I said before about why the feature for directly opening the captive portal page doesn't always work on iOS and Android. It's not actually a problem with the phone. It's a problem with the network not supporting the feature. You see, there's a network standard called RFC 8910, which defines how routers can advertise the actual direct URL of the captive portal. Specifically, there's these three DHC options that you can configure in the router. And you can see that they're described here in the Apple developer documentation. And the reason there's three is because there's different possible network configurations, like whether it's IPv6 or not. Anyway, the reason support for it is kind of sparse is it's not like a simple setting that you set in the router. It has to actually support like an API service. So in my router settings, there is an option where I can manually enter DHCP options. But the thing is, this text field where you put a URL is not simply the URL to the captive portal. It has to be a URL to an API that will respond to the request in JSON, and part of the response has to label the URL. So it's kind of like you have to have extra code running on the server, which not every router supports. That's why it's very, very hit or miss whether or not a network is going to have that ability to show that on the router. So that is why it's still useful to use the never SSL. So yeah, hopefully that will now come in handy. And the next time you have to connect to a Wi-Fi hotspot, you'll remember these and it'll be easier. So let me know down in the comments whether maybe you tried this or you're gonna remember to try it in the future. Thanks again to Aura for sponsoring the video. If you wanna protect your data and take advantage of all the other features it has, go to aura.com/TheoJoe for a 2-week free trial. Link is in the description. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up. It helps me out. And if you wanna keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about a relatively new Windows feature that can really help you if Windows is acting up and corrupted and stuff. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.